Hi everyone, welcome to our channel Helm of Science. So in my previous videos I was discussing the chapter light. I was focusing on the part reflection of light in my previous videos. So just a recap of what we learned up till now is that suppose a ray of light is traveling through a medium, okay, an optical medium is traveling through, and if we keep an opaque surface over here, what happens is that the ray of light after falling on this opaque surface will be reflected back into the same medium, okay. And if I draw a normal at the point of contact between the two surface and the incident ray and the reflected ray, what happens is the angle of incidence becomes equal to the angle of reflection. Like this is the incident ray, this is the reflected ray, right. This is known as the law of reflection, right. So now suppose we take an instance where we are not keeping an opaque medium, okay. Instead of that, we are taking two different optical mediums, we can say, okay, which allows light to pass through it, okay. So let's say we take two different mediums, okay. This is medium one, this is medium 2. What is the difference between the previous case that instead of this this opaque surface, we are taking another transparent or an optical medium, okay, through which light passes. Now what happens is that initially the light will pass undeviated through medium 1, okay, it will pass undeviated, but now as soon as it falls on the surface which separates these two medium, what happens is that the light ray, like the previous case, won't be reflected back, right, it will pass through it. Now the question is, the big question now arises, that whether will it pass undeviated through this through this medium 2 as well, and it will follow the same path. This is the big question which comes into play, okay. So now this is observed, that let's draw a normal first. Now this is observed that whenever a light passes from one optical medium to another optical medium, the ray of light will bend. It will won't follow its original path, it will bend either towards the normal or away from the normal, which is dependent on the two mediums in question. The two mediums we take as pair, okay. This bending of light, this phenomenon is known as the refraction of light. So today from this video we will be focusing on the refraction of light, okay. So what is refraction of light? So we can write that refraction of light. So we can tell that refraction of light is the phenomenon of bending of light ray when it passes from one optical medium to another, okay. The phenomenon of bending of light ray when it passes from one optical medium to another is known as the refraction of light. So before going too much into the refraction of light, first we need to learn about mediums, right. So any medium which allow light ray to pass through it, these such mediums are called transparent mediums, as a whole they are called as optical mediums, right. So transparent mediums, some examples of transparent mediums are air, water, oil, glass, alcohol, anything which allows, etc., okay, which allows light ray to pass through it. These are known as transparent optical mediums, okay. So now The question is, why does refraction of light takes place? Why light bends? Okay. Now the cause of refraction is because of the speed of light. Okay. The speed of light in vacuum is 3×10⁸ meter per second. This is constant. Okay. This value we know, the speed of light in vacuum is 3×10⁸ meter per second. The speed of light in air is also as comparable to that of vacuum, it is slightly less, but we take it as constant, which is 3×10⁸. So in air also we consider it as 3×10⁸. But however, this constant speed of light in air and in vacuum and air, it won't be the speed of light will not be the same in case of water or any other substance. So speed of light will differ according to the medium through which it passes. Okay, so speed of light is different in different mediums. Speed of light is different for different mediums. This is the basic cause of refraction. The speed of light is different for different mediums, so when it passes from one medium to another medium, so the speed will increase or decrease, and for that reason there will be bending of light and hence refraction of light will take place. This is the basic cause for refraction. Okay, so we discuss about transfer mediums, optical mediums rather. So Optical mediums where speed of light will be more, I am denoting as V light is more, those mediums are called optically rarer medium. And on the other hand, where speed of light is less, those are optically denser medium. Okay, where the speed of light is less, the density of the medium is also greater, hence the speed will be less, and which are optically rarer medium, their densities are low, hence speed of light will be more. Okay, so how can we tell that it is more or less? If we compare between two objects, then only we can tell whether it is an optical medium or a optical denser medium. I'll give you an example. Let's say we know speed of light in air is 3×10⁸ meter per second, right? Speed of light in water will be less than that of air. That is very simple, that is very basic. However, if we take a speed of light in glass being a much more denser object than that of water, what will happen is that speed of light in water will be greater than case of when the speed of light in glass. Okay, so speed of light in water will be greater as compared to that of glass. However, if you compare water with air, then the speed will be greater in air, right? So we can tell if we take a pair of mediums, then if we compare between the two, then only we can tell which one is an optically rarer or a denser medium. So if I take an example, if I take a pair of air and water, the two mediums into question are air and water, as I discuss. So in this case, air will be the rarer medium and water will be the denser medium. So if we only compare between two mediums, then only we can distinguish between a rarer and a denser medium. So again, similarly, if I take water and glass, water or oil, water or glass, say, okay. So what happens is that in this case, water will be the rarer medium as compared to the other case. As the comparison is between glass, so in this case water will be the rarer one and glass will be the denser one. Okay, so you got the concept, right? So if we compare between two, then only we can tell whether it is a rarer or denser medium. Okay, so we'll understand it with an example. Let's say the medium one is air. Okay, medium two is water. So initially what happens is the ray of light will be passing in air undeviated until and unless it falls on the surface which distinguishes the two mediums, okay, the interface. Okay, so what happens instead of going along the same path, what happens, there will be bending of light, right? Let's draw the normal first. Okay, I've drawn the normal at the point of incidence at the interface of the two surfaces. Okay, so instead of following the same path, what happens is that it will bend. Now the question is whether it will bend towards the normal or away from the normal. I told you, right, there will be like two cases where it will be bending towards it or away from it. Okay, so in this case, if you notice that initially the ray of light was in air, okay, so it is a rarer medium, and after it is passing from a rarer to water, that is a denser medium, right? So it is passing from rarer to denser medium, and what is the case here is that the speed of light will, the speed, what will happen to the speed when it causes from travels from rarer to denser, it will decrease, right? Speed will be decreasing. And for this case, in such cases where it travels from rarer to denser medium, or we have to remember that as its speed decreases, the light ray will bend. Sorry, the light ray will be bending. Sorry, instead of going along the same path, it will bend towards the normal. Okay, this we have to keep in mind. Okay, so when a light ray travels from a rarer to a denser medium, it will be bending towards the normal. Okay, and this is the angle of incidence and this is the angle of refraction. Okay, so naturally the angle of incidence will be much greater than that of the angle of refraction. This is the observation we see when light travels from a rarer to a denser medium, right? So light bends towards normal. Now if we consider the opposite case, let's say the medium one is now water, medium two is now air. Okay, we have reversed the scenario. Okay, so initially it will pass undeviated. Okay, now instead of following its same path, what will happen is that there will be a deviation from its path, right, as it is traveling from one medium to another. Now in this case, the medium one is a denser medium, right? However, and the medium two will be a rarer medium. So light is traveling in this case from a denser to a rarer medium. So naturally what will happen when it passing from a denser to a rarer medium, what will happen is that speed of light will be increasing. Speed of light will be increasing, right? So when the speed of light increases, what will happen is that the ray of light will be bending away from the normal. This is the observation we get. Okay, so when the ray of light passes from a denser to a rarer medium, what will happen is its speed will increase. As a result, its distance will also it will bend away from the normal. Okay, so what are the observations we can concur from here is that angle of incidence is now lesser than the angle of refraction, right? And the light bends away from normal. Okay, so these are the two cases where we explain what happens, what is the scenario when it passes from rarer to denser and the vice versa, right? So we have now discussed what are the causes of refraction. We have discussed few scenarios, what is the nature of light rays when it passes from one medium to another, from one rarer to denser or denser to rarer. So now we'll discuss few real life examples where we are like the refraction of light is exhibited, this phenomenon is exhibited. Few examples we from daily life we can which we can observe which is a cause of refraction of light. Like few examples I can tell is that like the base of the of a tank, the water tank, it seems as if it is raised, right? Now if we immerse a pencil inside a tub of water, what happens is that the pencil seems distorted, right? It will be somewhat dispersed at the interface of the water and the water surface, right? Another example we can commonly see is that if we take a tub of water, we place a coin at the bottom, right? If I place a coin at the bottom of a tub containing water, what will happen is that we see that the coin is a bit raised. This is the observation we get. If I place a coin at the bottom of a tank and we observe that it seems a bit raised when we see from the outside. Okay, why this happened? This happens. This is a direct cause of the refraction of light. Okay, so I'll explain why this happened. So now in this case, the light ray from the coin will fall into our eyes, right? So light rays will travel from water, which is a denser medium, to air, which is a rarer medium, right? So what happens is that, let's say a light ray comes from the coin. So what happens is that, if I draw normal over here, what happens is that as it is passing from a denser to a rarer medium, if we like recollect what we studied so far in this video, it will be bending away from the normal, right? So it will bend away from the normal. Okay, it will be bending away. Again, I'll consider another light ray. This one will also bend away, and this will fall to our eyes. Okay, these are a human eye. So if I retrace it backwards, if I retrace the steps backwards, sorry, if I retrace these refracted rays backwards, it will join somewhere over here. And because of this refraction of light, the coin appears as if it is a bit raised. So this is one of the most common examples which we see in our daily life, where we see that a coin, if we place a coin at the bottom of a tub containing water, it seems that the coin is a bit raised. So this is the diagrammatic representation why we seem like it is seen like that. Okay, this is the direct cause for refraction of light. So this will be all for this video. We will continue further and we'll learn more concepts about the refraction of light, more things related to the refraction of light in our future videos. So stay tuned and do like the video. Thank you.